leaves are turning brown.
Good morning!
Hippo!
We are sitting at another place. I'm sitting on the couch with my Halloween pillow because it's very cozy. It's very matchy-matchy. I really adore it. So this is where we are sitting today, doing reading. I actually thought that I would do a reading for, well, maybe I actually should do for all the elements. So I might start out with air and then we are going to take the rest. So what I'm going to do first is to do some channeling, do some intuitive reading. I just zoned out because I was guided to take another deck. Okay. But I do have a lot of decks laying here so that I can take that. But I'm going to do an all-in-all energy for air signs, and then there will be timestamps down below because I'm going to go into Gemini, Libra and Aquarius. I think that's what we are doing. Let me take the other deck. I just did a pregnancy shoot with a returning customer because last time I took pictures of her, she was also pregnant. And the little boy was a part of the shoot this time, which was so fun. You know, it was so funny to see the baby that's been in the stomach last time I took pictures of them all. Sounds complicated. But let's see what we can get for you guys. So air signs. I did hear time to celebrate, so there will be time to celebrate. And I think that we all have been in this energy of we have waited long enough, or we have waited for a long time. We feel like we have waited for a long time. But I also feel that there's a reason why we had to wait. And I feel that I heard someone say, makes sense with what I felt, because I felt this, you are there but not yet. And it did come up in other readings the past days that we are already doing the work that we are supposed to do, or we have done the foundation of what it is that we're supposed to do. Now we are in a circle where we have to make decisions. So you're watching, you are in a circle, I don't know why I want to say circle, where, well, maybe because you're going round and round because you have to make a decision, which fits well with the reading that I did yesterday with the story with Noah. So we do have rest and reconsider, and we do have the flow card, which is number 10. I actually think that I am going to make this for September. So all elements get a reading today for September. What's going to happen in September? Rest and reconsider. Nine of Wands. Actually interesting because he's wearing pink, or he's wearing purple. And, you know, this is the element of wands represented by the color purple. You're so close. I do feel, again, it fits well because you guys are so close. You can see, you can almost see and taste victory. You know that you are going in the right direction, or you will have this feeling of feeling this inner peace because you know that you are in the right direction now. You are facing the right direction. For some of you, there might be something that stops you. Trying to figure out why I should put the cards. But I feel that... I couldn't remove my laptop. I feel that it's connected with decisions. And it's a very emotional decision. That I say we air signs, because I'm a Libra, so yeah. Yeah. The base chakra. It might be because of money that some of us, or some of you, well, you know, me included sometimes, we do have a tendency to be way too much in our minds. We are overthinking a lot of things. And we have to rest and reconsider. Maybe not reconsider, but we have to rest so that things can flow. Makes sense why we have to flow card, or why we have the Wheel of Fortune, because it's the Wheel of Fortune. You have to make things flow. Everything is coming together. You can actually sit back and enjoy what you have created. But it's also about not giving up. I just saw the spider card. It is Halloween, so we are officially using the Halloween deck. You have come a long way. If some of you guys are considering something when it comes to a project or a job, if you are confused about if this is the right thing for you, you need to, again, rest. You need to take a time out and really think about, is this for me? We do have the Vampire reverse, so some of you guys might have someone who is a energy vampire, someone who is stealing your ideas. Maybe that's why some of you guys might even, you know, take the time out, like going somewhere, traveling somewhere, keeping someone at distance, also because we have the red here around. So it is something that's like, it's the base of the problem. It's the one thing that steals your energy that you are reconsidering. This can be the wrong job, this can be a person. We also have the Bambrock. Maybe some of you guys... I have this feeling that some of you guys can wait for this, like, this Halloween season. I'm going to take the book because then I can't remember what that card is about. So let's see. What is that card about? Bring more sweetness into your life, I heard. Bring more sweetness. When you pull the Bambrock card, it indicates a curiosity to know what is ahead, but it's important to balance that with the now. It's the same story, the same energy. There is this curiosity for what to come. Like, you know that something is happening around you, you can feel it. But at the same time, you also need to go with the flow and make decisions, because there is decisions that needs to be made. I feel that we should go into details with all signs. Yeah, with all air signs. So I will take Libra first. So I will take whatever cards wants to come out for Libra. I do not have a table, so you know, I am trying. So let's see, Libra. What is the message for Libra? I did hear go with the flow. You have your own card here, but this reversed. Yeah. Two of Wands, Justice reversed, and Seven of Swords reversed. Some of you guys are not listening to your intuition when it's about making a decision. Obviously, some of you guys might be air sign letting go of another Libra. It might be someone who was sneaky in the past, someone who was cheating on you. Doesn't have to be a Libra, but there might have been an air sign of someone else who cheated on you, or someone who is keeping you stuck in the past. Someone who might actually, well, be the energy vampire, or someone who is just still in the back of your mind, because us air signs, we do have the tendency to be a lot in our headspace. We think a lot, and sometimes it's like a child, a toddler, running around with OCD. That is us Libras. I think it's for all air signs, but us Libras, we do have it bad. We are OCD children running around wild when we allow our mind to run wild. Maybe some of you guys are also sick and tired of someone who's not making a decision. There is something that you need to choose between, or there's something that you need to wait on. That makes sense, because she is like in this position of waiting, like she's longing for something, which makes sense with this card. There is this curiosity energy, and you know that it's so close, you know that you want to go, but at the same time there is also this energy of letting things flow naturally. Whatever it is, it's going to come your way, but you need to let it come naturally. I feel that is the message for Libra. I don't know why I actually took Libra, because I should have taken the Libra card fell out. Well, maybe there is a reason why I took Libra first, because I should have taken Gemini. But let's take Gemini now. Okay, Gemini. What is the message for Gemini for September? Whoa, three cards fell down. Okay. Yeah, you're also too much in your mind, but you're also releasing it. You're realizing something and moving on. Maybe you are dealing with a Libra. But we do have the Ace of Swords. So some of you guys, in the beginning of September, you might still have this, like, again, the OCD child in your mind running wild. But you're going to release it with the Five of Swords reversed. I did speak about number five yesterday, because five is all about lessons in life, which is funny because the Eight of Swords also came up in that reading. If you haven't seen it, you might need to see it. It's funny because I do feel that air signs, we release things, we release whatever keeps us stuck, and that is what's moving us forward. Again, reconsider, rest and reconsider. That is the main energy here. Let things flow and listen to your base chakra, because it's whatever makes you stable right now. Whatever you feel makes you, I did hear someone say unstable. Whatever makes you unstable needs to go. I do feel that is your message, Gemini. So let's take, listen to your intuition, I just heard. Let's take Aquarius. This is going to be like a quick magical reading. But Aquarius, what is happening for you? You got your own card. Well, I'll be damned. You are manifesting. I do feel a lot of you Aquarius people, you actually already made a decision. You are resting, or you took the time out to rest. To listen to yourself, to be like, what do I need? Where do I want to go? What else can we get for King of Pentacles? Maybe you are becoming more stable. You're going after your dreams and desires now. You're finding a new job in September, or you're going after a new project. Like, I feel like for some of you, because Aquarius, you can be very quirky. You can sometimes be like the OCD child. You guys can't be that. So I feel like something happened that made you calm down, that made you very serious. Like, suddenly you know where you're going. Or it's someone that you, wow, yeah. Or it's someone that you're dealing with who is suddenly like, I know where I'm going, I know what I want to do. Do have the Nine of Wands. Yeah. Maybe you want to move to another country. Maybe you want to be around the right people. I heard that. But I also feel that someone said that to you. Someone said, well, be around the right people. Or be around the right surroundings. There's news and new ideas coming your way. And I do feel that you're going to go after it. It's like someone turned on the light with you. Someone turned on the light suddenly. Suddenly you just see things clearly. If you feel stuck right now, just wait for September, because September has a whole different kind of energy than the last month has. Like, things are finally going to flow, but they are flowing quietly. They are not, you know, again, it's not a fast movement. And we can thank Capricorn energy for that. And we are going to be in this Capricorn energy until December. So you better, you know, be comfortable in this energy. You need to learn to put your ambition and passion together. Like, again, be the OCD child that you are, but turn it down a notch. Not much, just a little bit. I do feel this is going to be everything for the air signs. I hope you guys could use this little input. I am obviously going to do September readings for all signs, but I feel like this was just like a little, you know, while we are waiting for the bigger readings. But if you are in need of a private reading, healing session, or removal of blocks, all information is down below. You can also go support me on Patreon, and you can learn about spells and other magical things. All information is down below. But with that, thank you guys for watching. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.
Now, I'm not ready, not just chill.